Okay, so it's a new month, we have new energy. So I am here to open our series on gratitude. And we know we should be grateful for all things, right? But sometimes we can't feel or find that energy in our hearts, you know? We say thank you, and we know we mean it. And sometimes we feel it, and sometimes we just think it. You know what I'm talking about? Yes. All right. We say it because I'm supposed to, and I'm grateful, but I'm just not feeling it. So, common event for some, perhaps. We teach our children to do that all the time, and when their little faces look at you and they say, okay, thank you, you know they're not feeling it either. But in reality, gratitude is something we feel. We feel it when we give it, and we feel it when we receive it. It's not just the two words of thank you. It is greater than that. It's something that is an energy that is to be felt. Everybody agree?
Yes.
All right, take a breath. We're going to set that aside for a moment. Set that aside for a moment. Now we're going to talk about me. A couple of months ago, I decided I should clean out my car. Not that the car is dirty, but I have a console. Somebody have a console between the two front seats? And it seems to be a catch-all. And as I'm putting my sunglasses in, I realize I've got tapes from classes and services from Olo so many years ago from InterQuest. And I thought, well, I just don't want to throw them out. I will listen to each one, and then I will decide whether it needs to be recycled or treasured forever. Mind you, these are tapes. And so I began my process, and as I'm listening to the services, whenever I tell a story about myself, normally I go, oh yeah, yeah, I remember that. Oh, that was fun, yeah. I listened to this tape, and I was shocked, because as I'm listening to myself speak, I have no conscious memory of what I'm talking about at all. So I wanted to share it with you. I had Noel transcribe it for me. Right, and this was a January 2002 service, so we're talking about 2001. I had a dream a couple of months ago. It was early December, late November. It was one of those dreams that is so real, it wasn't a dream. I was standing before a judge, just me and the judge. He said something along these lines. If you were granted more time on the earth plane, what would you use it for? And I knew this was an important question because it was about me staying here on the earth. And so, if I were granted more time on this earth plane, what would I use it for? In my mind, I knew this was a very important question. I needed to say what he wanted me to say. Because I wanted to stay, so I felt I had to have the perfect answer. And so my mind, you know how it flips so fast, so I went to karma. Oh, I could do more karma. I could learn more lessons. But I can't say that. I have to be true. The answer has to be true for me from my heart. I just can't say what I think he needs to hear. So I was standing before the judge, and only one word came out of my mouth. I said blessings. And when I said it, my whole body vibrated in truth. If I was giving more time on the earth plane, what would I use it for? I would use it for blessings. Blessings to receive from me, blessings to give to others, blessings to be a part of the creation of blessings. And this felt so good to me. I did not want to stay here and work anymore. I didn't want to do more karma. I didn't want to do any more lessons. I wanted to do blessings. And as I listened to that, I was startled. I immediately looked at the date and went, oh my gosh, it's been 11 years. How am I doing? I don't know. I'm 11 years into my extended time frame, and my promise to self was to be a part of blessings. So immediately, you know, I had to figure out what a blessing was. So I looked it up, and the dictionary gives us a very sweet definition of it. Blessings are something that promote happiness or prosperity. Sound good? Also, blessings are things that connect us with God. when we make something holy. You know, as ministers, we're always asked to bless this. People will buy a piece of jewelry and ask it to be blessed. They'll, you know, we bless babies, we bless marriages, we bless anything people ask us to. And that is by praying and connecting with God and asking that the divine light of pure love move into this object, thing, or person. So blessings are bringing happiness and prosperity, but they're also to connect one with that higher realm with God. So we bless our food, yes? We bless these events, we bless each other. It feels like, a blessing feels like giving a greater energy of good or a God energy of good. So, how do we bless each other? So, I've asked David Fuller to come up, and he's going to show us blessings and how they occur. So, David has been living his life, and he has abundance of goodness that he owns. Abundant prosperity. You might want to get on this side. Abundant prosperity, abundant energy, and he is just ready to bless somebody with it. And Sarah Moss is in need of a blessing. Sarah has been feeling quite poorly recently.
She needs a blessing.
She needs some prosperity, some energy of happiness. So David, in his abundant, having achieved all this goodness, offers a blessing to Sarah. Now, that is how a lot of people give blessings. I of my greatness do bestow upon thee one petal of all that I have. But it doesn't feel like a blessing, does it? It feels almost as if you're giving down to the person. They are not as highly evolved as you might be, and you are giving of your abundance to them. This is never a blessing, giving down to someone. So, a true blessing occurs when there is joy present, a joyful giver and a joyful receiver. So,
would you hold your hands out, please? Let me give you a real blessing. I hope I got enough for you.
Blessings receive. And see the joyfulness?
Yes.
Wow.
Wow.
I do this. I don't want that. Give it to myself.
Here you go, Holly.
You just can't stop a blessing. They have to go round and round. And then before you know it, the blessings come back and return a thousandfold to the giver. Can you see how joyfully giving of what we have? David is now ultimately blessed. Yes. Thank you. Does it make you want a flower? When we're finished, everyone can have a petal of blessing to take home and put it somewhere. We as people are the energy of joy and light. As we share of our light, only light goes out. And that light cannot be stopped or contained. It continues to move. And it always returns to us. Did you notice that in the lavender that returned, there were some of the red that went out? It always comes back in light consciousness. And did you notice something about Sarah when she received the blessing? Was there joy? Mm-hmm. And was there a bit of gratitude? Mm-hmm. There was a bit of gratitude. Gratitude is an automatic response when we are blessed. Gratitude is, we're grateful for the greater that we receive, we're grateful for the gift. It's an automatic response in the blessing. So, how can we receive greater blessings in our world? How can we be a part of greater blessings in our world? So, I have a little formula for us to look at. Most of us work Yes, we've contracted with someone. We take our skills out into the world, and we said X number of dollars equals I give you this. We work, and we get a paycheck. For most of us, that equals an equal energy exchange. I work, I get my check, and it's equal energy exchange. For some of us, and I have known people who worked in environments where the boss actually looked like David in the first scenario, handing the paycheck out, oh, here you go. Thank you for being here. You know, just a not a part of the joyful expression. When we work for an exchange and we get our paycheck, we have done our job. Equal exchange. What about if we change that formula? What about if we gave our energy and gave more? Decided that we would be a blessing for where we worked. How many of us actually call forth prosperity for the company you work for? Oh, fabulous. Look at those hands. I am proud of you guys. I am proud of you. And I bet each one of you have been with companies that were struggling. But even the most powerful ones, even the ones that have the greatest stable financial condition, we can pray for their prosperity. We can be a blessing to them. You could bless your phone as you make your phone calls at your office. You could bless everything. You could ask that greater light move. I certainly have greater light to give. Greater light can move through me in this environment to bless this environment. Then the formula changes. I give my work, which I've contracted to do, but I've also given a blessing. I get my paycheck, which is contractually what I agreed to do, but there's something now that comes from my boss that's different. It's an honoring, it's a joy, it's a recognition of my light, and it may come back to me as gratitude, as love, as acceptance. And then everything expands. Do you see how simple it is? How simple it is? I know back 30 years ago, when I was in corporate, 30 years ago, I always prayed for the prosperity of my company. Everybody knew it. Oh, they all knew it. And I was in cash management, and I had five companies that I had to keep going. And I played the float very well because there was not enough money. And my boss walked in one day. He bought, just come from a trip visiting a vendor who we owed a lot of money to. And he had written a check to them while he was there. And he stood at my office door, and he laughed and smirked at me. He said, well, Cindy, I just wrote him X number of dollars. I said, there's not X number of dollars in the bank account. He said, well, we'll just see how your angels take care of this one. And he walked out. And I prayed. And I said, oh my goodness, not only is that going to bounce, and these are vendors I have personal relationships with. I'm not going to let my vendors down. You know, and the most amazing thing happened. This was on a Friday. That following Monday, when the check hit, the bank made a $10,000 error and put $10,000 into our checking account that was not ours, was just enough for the check to clear. The next day, a receivable paid early. I got several hundred thousand in the account the next day, and the bank found their error, which I would have told them about the next day. Blessings. Of course, I marched into my boss's office and explained the whole thing, and he shook his head. But the company was run with the greater good. Everything was run with the greater good. We can be a blessing not only in our physical labor situations, but think about your personal lives. How often do we approach moving into relationships as a blessing? A lot of us are looking at holidays now, where we're going to be Thanksgiving and Christmas with family that we don't see very often. How many of us move toward that family commitment, trying to get through it, whereas we could go to that family commitment being a blessing to it, taking our energy and looking at it differently. I don't have to be what I've always done now. I'm going to be a blessing. Whether it's received or not, it will move. The blessing will move. It may not be received by the intended target, but someone will receive it. And you, when you leave, will have gotten more than you contracted for. It will return to you. All right. Blessings create gratitude. Gratitude creates blessings. Does this make sense? Gratitude is actually the highest form of unconditional love. Do you realize that? When you're in that space of gratefulness, you are feeling such love for a person, for a situation, for God, and there are no thoughts of attachments, there are no expectations, there is simply a state of pure love flowing from your heart. Gratitude is the highest state of unconditional love. And you know it and you feel it. So, we are actually in that moment touching God's abundance. When unconditional love is flowing, what is God? Unconditional love. When unconditional love flows through us, we are one with God, and we're touching that abundance of God consciousness. And in our gratitude expressing, we are blessing. Blessing is about lifting into greater happiness and prosperity. Do you see how it's this beautiful circle of life? All right. And I really would like us this month to think about all the areas that we could begin to shift in our world. Typically, November is a time of releasing and letting things go and just closing the door on many things as we're preparing for the next year in a month. But let's use this month as a time of, instead of closing doors, as a time of redesigning doors, as a time of opening doors, as a time of really becoming greater than we have been. And, you know, I scour the scriptures looking for stories of gratitude, stories of thankfulness. And unfortunately, we do not have in either book that we've received many of Jesus' prayers where he would turn to God and thank God. We have a few. But you know every time he blessed the food to break it, he was connecting with God. Every time he did a healing, he was connecting with God. When his disciples said he couldn't do the healing, and he said, you forgot to pray, you forgot to connect with God. His whole life was an attitude of gratitude to Creator. His whole life was thanking God for everything that came. This beautiful energy of knowing the human is human, the divine is eternal. And as the divine moves through each one of us, we feel that connection with energy that surmounts every human-created obstacle. And then we're in that energy of God. So, I wish that we had more of the prayers. I wish we had more of the examples of his turning to spirit. But we know every time that you read the word praise, in some of the songs, the word is praise. It's getting archaic in our language today. We don't walk around very much saying, praise
the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Sometimes we do say praise God when we're pulling out of a very dire situation. But for the most part, that word is losing its use in our language today. But every time you read praise, you can really understand that that is thank you at the highest level. Praise is thank you. Thank you at the highest level. Above all, thank you. So, you've heard it said to give thanks in all things. But I would say, why not be a blessing in all things? If we are a blessing in all things, we will live in a state, a perpetual state of gratitude. We will live in a perpetual state of gratitude. And then you'll feel it. It won't be just a word. It won't be an obligation. It will actually be an energy that moves from your heart out into the world and back. So we're going to go within and do a nice meditation today. So put your feet on the floor. And just breathe and feel that beautiful love of God surrounding you. Feel as if you are just in a beautiful column of light. And I want you to let yourself relax. And as the light gets brighter and brighter, just gently feel yourself lifting up. Feel your desire to touch that Spirit of God for a moment. And let yourself lift up the column of light. lifting above all the worries and concerns that you may have in this earth. I want you to lift into a space where you can feel your own spirit, your own soul, your own divinity. And when you hit that space, just stay, pause. Feel the energy all around you. Just notice the color. Notice whatever you sense or feel. And I want you to notice if the energy in your spirit, in this space you see, your life, is moving. Is there motion? And feel that love of God with you. And ask Jesus Christ to stand by your side. And ask to become aware. This is me. Everything I see, moving, non-moving, formed, unformed. And feel your heart begin to open. See if you can find gratitude for what is you right now in this moment. God, I thank you that I have this space that I have created. I thank you for all of the experiences of my life, whether viewed as positive or not. I thank you that I had the right to choose, and I had the right to learn. I thank you for the details of my life. And as you say those words, just feel the energy. Feel the peace. And now for a moment, feel your heart. And I want you to ask now to be a blessing in your life to yourself first. Ask to be a blessing to this space in which you find yourself. I ask that blessings flow through my heart to this space. And you may feel a color moving through. You may feel an energy moving through. I ask to bless the space of me, my soul, my spirit. And you should feel things become different, perhaps beginning to move, perhaps beginning to lift, perhaps taking on a different color. And now I want to know what it feels like to be a blessing in my world. Feel the energy all around you, and now become aware of the details of your world and see the energy of blessing moving through that. Focus on where you work or give your time and talents. How would it look being a blessing there? Feel the love. Now focus on your relationships. Whatever comes to your mind is fine. What would it look like if I was a blessing in my relationships? To feel the light. And now the world at large, just the world. What would it feel like? What would it look like if I was a blessing to the people in my world? And let your love flow. Come back into this space and feel your heart and see the spirits you are and notice any differences. I choose to be a blessing on this earth, for myself and for the world. I choose to live in perpetual gratitude for life. Feel your heart expanding. And if that feels right to you, take it in. I choose to be a blessing to myself and to this world. And I choose to live in a state of perpetual gratitude. Feel the light surrounding you. Feel our Father, Mother, God just holding you. And breathe. God, we love you so. We just send our gratitude in this moment. Feel you are connected to the greater abundance of God. And let's bring that back into this time and space. Breathing, and gently let your focus come back to where you sit, feeling your body, feeling your heart open. When you're ready, you can gently open your eyes. Did you see yourself bigger? Remember the visions that came, no matter what they were. If it was you walking through the mall, greeting everybody, if it was you being tender with a child or a lover, remember what you saw. This is how we can live that perpetual state of blessings and gratitude. I am grateful for all the blessings in my life, those I give and those I receive. Say yeka.
Yeah.
And so.